The purpose of the Level 2 art course is to provide a bridge to the Level 3 courses that we offer. So we try and provide a grounding in as many different skills and materials and techniques that can lead on to the different Level 3 courses that we've got, or an apprenticeship or employment, as we possibly can. So we try out lots of things. It gives you an opportunity to develop a portfolio, or maybe make up for not having quite got the grades that you were hoping for. And it also gives you a chance to learn to study in the way that will suit the Level 3 courses. The structure of the course, we start off with an introductory project to cram as many different skills into the start of the course as we can. Then we do three different short projects as an exploratory stage, so a two-dimensional project, a three-dimensional project, and a time-based project. That runs alongside a dedicated drawing unit, because drawing is a sort of key skill for all of the creative pathways that we offer. But the main focus of the course, and the part of the course that gets you the grade overall, a pass, merit or distinction, is the final major project, which accounts for roughly a third of the course, and that starts around Easter and runs through to the end of the course, and that's a project that you design yourself in response to a series of set starting points. And then we mark that, and that gets you your final grade for the year. It's just a year-long course. On successful completion of the course, if you achieve a merit or above, that's the entrance requirements for the progression to the Level 3 courses that we offer. So that's the main aim of us, is to get as many students through progression as we can. Our entrance requirements for the course, we ask for 5 threes, including a creative subject.
Hello, my name's Carla. I'm the current course manager of Year 1 Art and Design. The art and design is based about building skills within a wide range of visual disciplines: photography, graphics, textiles, ceramics, sculpture, mixed media, painting, drawing, collage, print. So all of those sort of things you'll be shown, and some you might have done before, some you haven't, and it's about enriching your sort of creative skills, developing a portfolio, sort of traditional hard portfolio, or an online one that you could progress if you want to go up to a higher level HE course or a level 4 course within college. You'll need a sort of digital portfolio to represent your artwork. It's very practical, it's taught practical, hands-on, working with resources, materials, and you're supplied a lot of the initial resources. However, as the course progresses, you are expected to buy small amounts of equipment, materials, just to sort of back up your own work. So in the workshop stage, it's all supplied, from like intaglio plates to lino, and then obviously you will have your own tools, hopefully, that you'll buy and sort of invest in. If you're going to do art as a career, you need to invest in your own materials and resources. We do go on trips when we're allowed to. I mean, currently in the situation we can't, but however, as the year progresses, we will go on trips, and next year hopefully we'll be doing like the Tate in London, or we might go to Pallant House in Chichester. So we sort of do local and sort of national sort of galleries within the country to help build up your creative skills and knowledge. Obviously, it's good to go and see the artwork in real life rather than it being just out of a book or online. So it's obviously workshop led with lectures and demonstrations, very sort of practical. But obviously to back that up, we have sort of things like Google Classroom, where we use that as a digital format to sort of do research and handing assignments. So you'll do written assignments where you have to hand those in on a weekly or sort of monthly task. You'll sort of set things that you need to complete within that time frame. And obviously working in sketchbooks is a very traditional way to work within the creative industries. So you're building up a book of sketches and ideas that inform your work, and then hopefully from that, you know, we can help you and guide you to sort of create outcomes from that. So obviously the course is done through assessment and it's ongoing. You'll get sort of one-to-one feedbacks during sessions as you're working practically, you know, what you need to sort of do if you're not doing it correctly. But also you'll get an online assessment form which you can view, and we view, and we update it on a regular basis to give you feedback on how you're doing. So you might be an expert at drawing, but you might not be an expert at research. So we then sort of say, well, have you tried looking at this or doing that? You know, and within that, hopefully, we'll find areas that you can improve on and obviously enrich those that you're possibly very good at to start with, like the drawing and painting. But, you know, we do a lot of things that are practical, like ceramics and sculpture and mixed media. So you hopefully will learn a lot of new skills as well as sort of ones that you've probably done at school. I've talked about progression, so there is a progression route, but again, just to confirm that you do, it's part of the course to build up an amazing portfolio of work that you can then take forward for a career in HE, hopefully sort of somewhere in the creative industry, which is one of the largest growing industries in the southeast as well. It's an amazing thing. It's over 50% of the jobs within the creative industry tend to be in the southeast where we live, and it's one of the biggest growth industries as well within the country.
Fashion industry directly contributed $32.3 billion to the UK GDP in 2017. Fashion remains a major UK employer with 890,000 jobs supported across the industry. New UK employment figures rank fashion as almost as large as the financial sector. We offer UAL Level 3 Extended Diploma in Fashion, as it is a programme that offers both UCAS points and also provides students with the appropriate skills for employment, and therefore allows students the opportunity for both direct entry into the fashion industry and onto higher education pathways. The UAL Level 3 in Fashion is well recognised by universities that offer higher education programmes in this subject, and the course has a high number of students each year that choose this option in order to specialise. The course nurtures creative potential and provides the underpinning knowledge of the fashion industry to allow students to enter into a variety of fashion job roles, such as design, promotion, marketing, styling, pattern cutting, garment construction. The course aims to cover a variety of skills and knowledge that create the best opportunity for real-life working environment. These areas include health and safety, using industry standard methods and equipment, working to live briefs and undergoing work experience. The course is also designed to develop transferable skills which are desirable to both employers and higher education, such as collaborative teamwork via photo shoots, fashion shows and exhibitions, and presentation skills via portfolio building, both digital and physical, CAD, and the ability to manage own time and meet deadlines via self-directed study. There is also a large focus on art and design theory via lectures, trips, residentials and independent study, not only for creative inspiration, but also so that the students develop an awareness of how their own design work fits into the wider context, which is essentially for the fashion industry. As stated, the fashion industry is almost as large as the financial sector, and the amount and types of jobs offered are vast. This course therefore aims to offer students some experience in a wide variety of areas in fashion, so that students can make a more informed choice about which career they wish to pursue, playing to their strengths. Although locally the fashion industry is weighted towards business and retail, this course embraces the industry as a global network and encourages students to seek opportunities beyond the vicinity, also encouraging social mobility.
Hi, I'm Martin and I run the photography and graphics course here at HSDC. I can tell you a little bit about the course. 2 year, equivalent to doing 3 A levels, and you're going to be learning sort of 50% photography, 50% graphics. So over the 2 years you'll learn loads of photography and graphics. We do a lot of traditional work and a lot of digital work as well. So as well as learning to use Photoshop, InDesign, Illustrator on the Macs, you'll work in the darkroom, you'll work with screen printing, you'll learn how to do page layout, you'll learn how to do typography. And the reason we combine both subjects is so that you become employable. So a photographer who can work with graphics and work with images, work with text, has a lot of skills they can offer a company, whereas someone that hasn't can be viewed as a bit one-sided. So if ultimately you can save a company money, then it's going to be a good thing. So we teach photography, we teach graphics. Some students come along, they're a little bit dubious about doing one or the other because they haven't studied it at school. It's fine. Often someone will come perhaps not keen on graphics, but at the end of the 2 years they'll love it and they'll go on and do a university course on it. Or someone won't be so keen on photography, but they'll really love it that. So over the 2 years, you're building a portfolio of images. You are trying to impress someone. As a visual practitioner, when you go to university or you want to get a job, you need a whole set of images to show them. So over the 2 years, you'll be building those images. About half the students from the course will go on to uni. The other half will go into apprenticeships, or set up a business, or look to find general work. But it's roughly half and half, and we will tailor that towards you in the second year. By the time you get to the second year, you've specialised really. So you've come, you've had a taste in photography, a taste in graphics, and you choose one of them, and then you really major it in the second year. So you do a big final project, lasts about 4 months, which you get to really explore the discipline that you've chosen to work in, whether that be the darkroom, digital photography, or indeed graphics, working traditionally or digitally. You get Creative Cloud as part of the course, so as well as 15 hours timetabled here, you'd expect it to work at home. And it's much better if you've got your own IT equipment, so a laptop or a MacBook or a PC, and then you can run Creative Cloud at home. You'll also do much better if you've got your own digital SLR as well, so that you can be amplifying what you've learned at college and practicing at home. Under normal times, we would go out as many trips as we can, so we go to London a lot, Brighton, and in the second year we go to Berlin for a residential, so you need to allow a little bit of money for that. Also, where we're an art course, we do a lot of printing of sort of high-end exhibition prints, so that adds up a little bit as well. So maybe if you budget £100 to £200 every year. So, 2 year course, we'd love to have you here. If you're creative, you need to have a creative GCSE and 5 other GCSEs, come and have a look.